Well, it's the next morning, and it's Christmas Eve proper, December 24th, and I still have a few more things to wrap for the family party, specifically the stuff in that pile. However, first, let's do a weather check. We'll start with visual inspection. And a relatively nice day in lovely South Florida as we do the nice zoom in to the ocean there. Very nice.
Right now in Pompano Beach, it's 77 degrees with mostly cloudy skies. Today's forecast has partly sunny weather, with a high of 81 degrees and a low of 64 degrees.
What's the weather like in Buffalo, New York?
Currently, in Buffalo, New York, it's 28 degrees with partly sunny skies. Today, you can expect snow flurries, with a high of 33 degrees and a low of 26 degrees.
Damn, one more degree and it would be 34, which rhymes with dirty floor. Read me my shopping list.
You have four items on your shopping list. Left testicle. Left testicle. Left testicle. Fish oil.
Yeah, real mature. Okay, for starters, I gotta give this a little bit of an upgrade, a little bit of a facelift. Now, I did adorn the back with some dragon duct tape, but we need to do something here. So I printed a piece of clip art. It does have the watermarks because I guess you're supposed to buy this piece of clip art, but whatever. And that should make it look a little better. Let me cut it down. Gee, look at the quality cut job I did. I mean, this is like, you know, art 101 or first grade or kindergarten art. I should have cut out all of the white. It sounded kind of racist, actually. We need to put some tape on there now. All right, so here we go. Longtime viewer, Nando, he said, Alfred, you haven't used any Justin Bieber duct tape. Unfortunately, I think I'm clear out of stock. Maybe there's a roll left on the studio side. I don't know. And if I do have a roll left, it's probably worth like millions. So what am I going to use instead? I will show you. I have like, you know, One Direction duct tape. One Direction. One Direction duct tape. There you go. So we're going to use this. And there you go, Nando. You got your freaking shout out. Now leave me alone. I don't know. You freaking tell me. Does this look any better? Oh yeah. Let's see how it fits in with the mix. Oh, just lovely. Yeah, let's pollute more Christmas trees at my crappy wrap jobs. Oh, and speaking of crappy wrap jobs, I have to tell you, to the friends that are connected on Snapchat, I am really getting such a kick seeing the pictures and the video clips of your crappy wrapping jobs. Really, it makes my day. I'm so glad I've inspired so many people and have certainly justified wrapping a gift that looks like shit. Nice. You know, there are two things that my young cousin Madeline enjoys. Number one is art, and number two is zombie dice. I was introduced to zombie dice by my nephew, Michael, Mike Mack. So these must be wrapped. And I have to make a comment about people that have artistic abilities. I mean, I can't even draw a stick figure. All right. And you see the type of artwork, especially from the younger family members. I mean, it's brilliant. I mean, really, you see that artistic ability at a young age. So let's wrap these things. I think Madeline's really going to get a kick out of them. You see, and this is where, like, I'm a total idiot and certainly mentally challenged. Like, a normal person would wrap these two items separately. I mean, because of the dimensions and whatnot. But no, we're going to do it the hard way. And stack the zombie dive on top of the, you know, the crayons or whatever the hell those things are. We'll probably have some rippage, but whatever. Let's give it a try. Clearly, I am a master of illusion. I am a master of illusion. A master beta of illusion. All right, so because from this angle, it looks pretty good, but, you know, that angle, looks like total dog shit, and we do have rippage, all right? But for all intents and purposes, and for years I thought it was intensive purposes, but no, the phrase is intents and purposes, it's done. Yeah, so I'll call this an artistic zombie rap. Don't forget to smash the freaking bow. Yeah, for Sabrina, I got that ocean wave projector. Now, she says bedroom with Madeline, so I think that both of them will have a ball having this, like, stuff beaming onto the ceiling. I might have to get one of these myself. I, as you know, I like stuff That lights up, duh.
So yes, you buy the bottled water and it comes in that packaging with, you know, the sheet of cardboard and the plastic and the bottles are contained in there. But here you go. Look at this. New for 2017. Let me show you. There it is. A work of art. A Dasani water wrap. Now, since it is an ocean, you know, wave projector, I mean, it makes sense because of the continuity with water. Beautiful.
Oh, for Olivia, I got her this light projection system. This doesn't do like the ocean wave effect, more like just like laser light shows on the ceiling. I might have to get myself one of these too, because again, yes, I like stuff that lights up. These were things I got on Amazon. But yeah, let's wrap it. Well, here you go, new for 2017. I call this a Think Geek catalog wrap. I mean, not a big deal. I pulled out the staples. And pulled out a bunch of pages, cut them down, and actually, it doesn't look that bad. It is, you know, eco-friendly. We are saving the environment, whoop-de-freaking-do. And yeah, nice. And bow smash.
Look, I almost didn't film Wrap 2017. I mean, I got a lot of, you know, messages and whatnot from the core viewers, and I'm running out of freaking ideas, but quite frankly, I'm impressing myself a lot of new wrap techniques this year. So hopefully, you know, you will deploy these next year. Pollute the tree. That's the theme. Nice.
I got this for Angelina. This is one of my favorite toys from back in the day. So this toy has been around. I mean, it's old, like me. Spirograph. So it's mathematics. It's a bunch of gears and angles, and it creates these wonderful patterns. You stick a pin in the hole and you go around, and that's what it looks like. That's what the kit looks like. So we have these, you know, gears and holes in the gears, and we spin around the shape that you create. And I really can't articulate this properly, and it's certainly, like I said, there's mathematics involved. But you know, you can vomit out these type of things in an analog way. I mean, you shove a pen in the hole and you spin around, you know, whatever shape you build, and you make these really cool patterns, again, based on mathematics. I mean, it's not fractals. I mean, I don't know. Someone out there that knows math should be able to equate what is at the core of this, but it's really very, very cool, very enjoyable, very creative, and I'm sure there's a JavaScript that will do this on the computer. You know, here it is in its original analog format. Let's wrap it. Okay, because I like to encourage people to think outside the box, here's a new wrap technique. Let's use the reverse side of the gift wrap paper, okay? Because inherently, there is a very, very subtle pattern on the reverse side. So we're not wrapping it showing the beautiful Christmas trees. We're using the opposite side. Oh, like bizarro world. Here you go. Yeah, well, this just looks so plain. I mean, normally, oh, gee, you know, white wrapping, oh, very, very classy looking. No, it looks terrible and dull and boring. We need a graphic there. So I'm printing something now on the little inkjet. Okay, so let's look at the original graphic image. There it is. Quite beautiful, this truck with a shit ton of Christmas lights. And here it is printed. So what's the fail here? I'm obviously running out of, I think, red. So it looks like total crap. But definitely a lot better with the graphic image. Nice. So what did I call this? A white Christmas gear wrap. Yeah, it really is terrible. Oh, I'm sure Isabella's going to enjoy the ocean wave projector. And for this, we'll do like a Time magazine wrap. Let's pull some pages. Wow. I mean, does this look terrible or what? A good use of Time magazine. What do we call this wrap? We call it a fake news wrap. Whatever. Yeah, for Cousin Rich Jr., you know him. You know, he helped me with that Dell server setup years ago where we had the incident of the L Your Hardware vendor. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Right out of the effing box. Here we go. Why am I all excited? What am I looking at? Right effing now. Hardware malfunction. L Your Hardware vendor for support. Rich. What did we do?
I'll tell you what we did. We installed a freaking FireWire card and a freaking board for the backup device. That blue screen, this effing machine. I'm going to send this video to Dell.
Dell, we need you. Get over here right now.
You're talking to Michael?
Michael Dell.
Get him on. No, really, I'm serious. Get him on the phone.
No, I'm telling you, I got through.
You did?
Yeah.
Anyway, he drives a nice FF class flatbed truck, so I figured, you know, Forza would make sense, so he can like drive recklessly in the reality of the video game. So let's wrap it, but I think I'm gonna do a new technique. I'm gonna use this box of Kashi Golean cereal. This is part of my morning breakfast, my you know, diet. This plus a shit ton of fruit. But notice I kept, you know, the inner bag, which has like some dusting of the cereal still remnant in there. So I'm gonna put the game into the condom, and then, like, you know, that's the technique. Nice. So let's recycle and reuse this Kashi Golean cereal box. Okay, so the game is technically in the condom. There you go. Done. Oh, come on. This looks great. Even the colors are on point. I mean, what do we call this? We call it a Kashi condom wrap. And it works. You know, for Dave the Marine, I got him this Player Unknown's Battlegrounds, which supposedly is a hot PC game now ported over to the Xbox. This is the preview edition. It did cost money, though, so I hope I got the right thing. But I got him this because I thought it would, you know, enhance his PTSD from being in the front lines in Iraq. But everyone seems to be, you know, raving, whatever, about this game. I might have to get it myself, but I heard there's a lot of sniping involved. And quite frankly, I don't do well with sniping. Matter of fact, I get really pissed off when I get sniped. Many people on my friends list have been thrown off my Xbox One friends list from sniping me in Halo. You know who you are. Some of you are watching these crappy videos. Don't snipe me, it really pisses me off. Yes, one great thing that came out of the NASA space program, the race to the moon, is aluminium foil. And certainly by me saying aluminium is a shout out to my friends and viewers in the UK. Stimulate PTSD wrap and, you know, some death on the back with the skull and crossbones. And actually a little bit of the product is leaking through, but yeah, that works. And and we certainly thank Dave for his cervix in the Marines. Nice. So for Rich Senior's mother, Nancy, she's 90 now, God bless her. Her memory, her thinking, sharp as a tack, phenomenal clarity, fun on camera still, can roll with the jokes with me. This is senior family member Nancy. She's 89 years of age. She'll be 90 in September. Nancy, what's the secret to living long?
Happiness and family and coping with everything.
You said happiness? Happiness.
So bad.
Yeah, bad.
Just unbelievable. And she has a nice collection of collectibles. I got her this. A beautiful precious moments piece, and the moniker on this thing is wishing you the sweetest holiday, which you can make some type of a type 2 diabetes joke, but whatever. Let's wrap it for Nancy. And what better a box than a bodybuilding.communist box for the 90-year-old Nancy. And listen, I have to be a little bit kinder to her arthritic hands. I got arthritis in my hands too. So just only one piece of industrial duct tape, and we label this, you know, a still hard to open wrap. But there it is, quite lovely for Nancy. Yeah, Rich Senior and Malin have quite the collection of these precious moments as well, and they are really nice pieces. You get them at the local Hallmark store. This one is the annual snowman. I see. Normally, I would like cross out a couple of letters, so it would be like anal snowman, but like people save the boxes, so I don't want to wreck, you know, the collectability of the piece, but like the joke is inherently there. And what's the tune? Deck the Hall. So yeah, it's one of those snow globes, you know, like a biodome. So I let's just throw it in a freaking Trader Blow's bag. Okay, and with that snowman in the snow globe makes me think of a joke, and the joke is, why did the snowman pull his pants down? Why? because he heard the snow blower coming. But on bump. It's an old joke.
There it is. Quite lovely. And we call it the Snowmen Like Snowblowers Rap.
So I'm talking to my friend Nick. I said, Nick, you got to check out, you know, my new YouTube video, Rap Part 1. I think you'll enjoy it and you'll get a few laughs. He's like, okay. I go, yeah, it's not that long. It's about 9 minutes in runtime. And he's like, Alfred, you rapped for 9 minutes? I go, yeah. And he goes, how did you come up with lyrics for 9 minutes? And I'm like, not that type of rap. Gift rapping. I'm no, like, lyrical word master. Microsoft Word master. Anyway, yeah. So no, not 9 minutes of me rapping. It's 9 minutes of me rapping GIFs, not JPEGs, whatever. So I just wanted to share that with you. And another story. So I'm on the phone with my friend Bob out in Las Vegas, and he's in the hospital. And as I'm wrapping up the phone call, I'm saying, you know, and Bob, you know, Merry Christmas, Happy Hanukkah, you know, Happy Festivus, you know, Happy Kwanzaa, you know, whatever. And he says, well, Alfred, I wouldn't poo-poo any holiday. You never know who's on duty at the hospital. And I start laughing, and he goes, Alfred, why are you laughing? And my response was, well, Bob, you use the words poo-poo and duty in the same sentence. I don't know. I thought that was kind of funny. Whatever. I'm immature.
Well, time to wrap the Swarovski 2017 crystal. Yes, I've gotten a little bit better at saying Swarovski. Let's take a look at the crystal. Okay, so I'm going for those extra thumbs up, or really thumbs down on the cinematography. Let's simulate what it's going to look like on a Christmas tree. Look, once again, they do a nice job with these crystals. And of course, you know, a standard Alfred.TV joke, you know, for referencing a crystal, we follow it up with the word meth. So yes, the Swarovski, I still have trouble with the freaking word, the Swarovski 2017 crystal meth ornament. How's it look in front of the cube? Woo. So this is just amazing cinematography, folks. I hope you're freaking impressed. Yeah, crappy videos now presented to you in 4K. So I bought 23 of those freaking crystals for 2017. I don't know, 2018 probably going to experience some budget cuts. That number might go down, but I was able to squeeze 23 out this year. So there you have it. And let's wrap this thing. You know, and on a side note, while I am diligently wrapping the Swarovski crystals, let's not forget the true meaning of Christmas.
Vengeance.
Well, there you have it. There's a beautiful and elegant gift that now looks like total trash, because that's the way we do things here at Alfred.TV. Of course, you know, here's the professionally wrapped stuff, but now let's compare that to my wrap job with the Star Wars flyby. Wow. Look at this. Is this horrific or what? Yes. Yes. Another year, another Christmas tree will be absolutely polluted with my wrapping techniques. And I'm so thrilled to see and hear that some of you are emulating these fine wrap jobs. So let's do the wide angle shot. Wow. Wow, wow, wowsy wow. Those look almost as bad as that sofa, which I really gotta throw the fuck out. Anyway, there you have it.
More to come. Stay tuned.
But you go from the beautifully wrapped gifts and oh my, can you tell which ones I wrapped? Really stand out, don't they, Vin?
Yeah.
Mm-mm. Look like what? Starts with SH. Shit.
Dude, they look like shit.
I said ship, so.
You said ship?
Yeah.
I said shit. No, feces is medical. Say feces on three, ready? Feces.
Feces.
Welcome to Alfred.TV.